The one, the only, Arch Manning. Now, Arch is officially committed to the University of Texas. He put hashtag hook'em. He looks like an old man in this picture. I swear to God. Like, I know he's only in high school, but good gracious. He created a Twitter account specifically to come out and just do this in the most nonchalant way. The timing on this is absolutely absurd. Now, we always knew it was going to be between Texas and Georgia, and there were some people that thought Alabama might be involved and whatnot. If you remember, Texas tried to hire David Cutcliffe back in February, and Cut was then hired by the SEC to be assistant commissioner over football or something along those lines, right? So Cutcliffe was able to get in and see Steve Sarkisian's operation, etc. And Nelson Stewart, who is the Isidore Newman head coach, he's Arch Manning's coach, he did come out and say that Sark had a great game plan, a great recruiting plan, etc., that he really sold Texas. And it makes a lot of sense as to why Arch Manning would want to go to the University of Texas. Now, what does get confusing here is the logjam, right? Matt Zenitz tweeted this out earlier. He said, Texas quarterback group moving forward. Class of 2021 top recruit, Quinn Ewers. Class of 2020 top 70 recruit, Hudson Card. Class of 2022 four-star recruit, Malik Murphy. Class of 2023 number one recruit, Arch Manning. Now, Quinn Ewers and Arch Manning both have perfect 1.000 scores as far as their recruiting profile goes over at 247 Sports. So that is, I mean, just absurd. Just absurd. And when you look at this, Hudson Card going into this season and Quinn Ewers going into this season and Malik Murphy all have four or more years of eligibility left to play college football. And that's before Arch Manning even steps on campus. So you got a logjam here. Which ones are going to end up being out? And my guess would be that, now the way that this could work, obviously, I'm going to guess that Malik Murphy or Hudson Carr decides to transfer out after this season. That's my initial guess. After that, if everything goes according to plan, Quinn Ewers will head off to the NFL after next season, after the 2023 season, which would be Arch Manning's first season. So if you have a really good year this year, and then you have a really good year the next year, Quinn Ewers would only have to play 2 years of college football, so there is a way mathematically that it could work. Arch Manning would basically sit behind Ewers for one season. Now, of course, we all thought the same thing when we talked about Spencer Rattler and Caleb Williams at Oklahoma last year. But if you don't play all that well to start off 2023, the fan base gets a little louder, etc. Does Quinn Ewers want to have to deal with that? Parker at Stats of War on Twitter obviously has been all over this with TC Ewers. Yeah, he is calling it. He's been calling it for a long time. He thinks that Quinn Ewers will end up at TCU. There's a way that it could work out that they could both just end their careers at Texas, Manning and Ewers. But who knows at this point. But this is a huge get for Texas. A huge get. Steve Sarkisian, if you look at the timeline, all of the different quarterbacks that he has had drafted in the first round, it's tough to argue. It's tough to argue with that. He had Mac Jones 2 years ago. He had Tua Tagovailoa before that, etc. So there's a lot to like with all the stuff that he did at USC as well. Like, he has been involved with a lot of quarterbacks. So yeah, I don't think that it's a bad idea for Arch Manning to go to Texas, but you had to sell him on it. Right, that's the biggest thing. You had to sell him on the idea that that he could be successful at Texas when nobody else has to this point, really. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.